Google recently released a brand new AI platform called NotebookLM, and it may change how you do your research, how you do your note-taking online, and how you organize all your information. NotebookLM is basically an AI-powered notebook, but you could ask questions from all your research, you could organize your ideas in a brand new way, I think a much more organized way, and is powered by Google's latest AI Gemini model. Now, let me show you around NotebookLM. You could access it at notebooklm.google.com, and it may be limited based on your country right now. I'm in the US, it's available for me, but check to see if it's available in your country. Now, let me show you exactly how you use this. So they have some example notebooks here that you could jump into, but let me create a new notebook to show you exactly how this works. So first, you want to title your notebook. Now, the notebook is where all your notes about a very specific topic are organized. So you could make multiple notebooks based on each topic. So here, all my generative AI research is going to go here, and then I can make a generative AI course using all the notes that I take here, for example. Now, this is organized a little bit differently than any note-taking app you probably ever used or ever seen. On the left side here, all your sources are going to go here. So I'll show you what these sources are, but then in the center, this search box is only going to use Gemini to pull information from your sources, not from the open web. So there is no risk of hallucination. There is no risk of pulling information that is incorrect from different websites. This is only accessing things from your sources. So let me press the plus sign here to show you what sources are. So you could upload directly from your Google Drive, obviously a Google product, so it's connected to Google Drive. You could upload any PDF documents to it. You could upload any text file, or you could just copy and paste any text over here. This is going to become your sources, at least one source. And then you could press the plus sign here to add another source. So all your sources will show up here on the left side. Now, at the time I'm recording this, you could have 20 different files uploaded here inside of your sources. Each of them could have 200,000 words. So you could combine multiple files for a total of 4 million words as your source. So let me click over here and start adding some sources. I'll use my Google Drive here that I've connected my account to. Now, inside of this drive, I have all kinds of scripts for different skill leap courses we have. Let me go ahead and select a couple of these courses related to ChatGPT and DALL-E, maybe chatbot building, and let me go ahead and insert these here. And if you look on the left side, all those sources have been added to my library, okay? And let me add a source that's just a PDF as well, just to show you how that works. Okay, I'll upload this PDF. That's the top 100 AI tool list. And now that's been added over here. And you could always add copy text too. So copy text is just gonna give you this box right here where you could update your title with a source you got this from, and then type in any text or paste any text and insert this as well. Now here's where the power comes in, okay? If I click over here, it's gonna select all my sources. And then if I chat over here, if I start typing, it's only gonna talk to those 6 sources. It's not gonna have access to the open internet. It can't hallucinate. It could only pull from my clean data that I gave it that are from my own specific research and my own specific set of notes. So I'm gonna say, give me the top 10 keynotes over here. And it works just like any other large language model. This is powered by Gemini. So if you use Gemini on the Google website, it works the same way. Now it's gonna pull up some citations here. So it gave me the 10 key points with the citation where it got these from. So if I click on number 6, it goes and finds that data. So this is what's highlighted over here. And it pulled that from this very specific page. Okay, so I could see exactly what that is, custom GPT for entrepreneur script. And it pulled that information from there. Now, if I find this useful, let me exit here. If I wanna keep this note, I could just pin this note and it adds it over here. So that's one way to create notes. And it's giving me some other options over here for follow-up prompts. So I could actually see if any of these are useful or type my own. I could always take notes on my own as well. So if I press add notes, I could take notes about this specific topic and then it will save the note over here. And anytime I could click these notes, like for example, let me choose this one. I could click on the note and have a follow-up conversation, right? So I could say, create an outline from that set of 10 key points, and it's going to create a brand new note for me. Again, based on this note, if I want to chat with all my notes that I took over here, not from sources, right? So to chat with sources, all I had to do is select all sources or any individual source. I could always check just one of them too. Or in this case, if I don't want to use my sources, I could use my notes. So if I select all the notes, all three here, I could actually use this down here. You see how it gave me a quick option over here to summarize all my notes into a new note, right? And I could pin that summary over here as well. Now, if any of them don't make any sense, like this note, I didn't add anything in, so I'm gonna deselect all, and I'm gonna go ahead and just delete this note from the batch. Now I'm gonna interact just with one source. I'm gonna select this. What is this all about? And this is custom GPTs for entrepreneurs. So you gave me the full breakdown of exactly what that course is all about. Again, all the citations are going to be available, and you could just hover over them too. So you don't have to click to see where he pulled that information from. Now, as you could see, this is not a replacement for Gemini or for ChatGPT. This is just a whole different way for taking notes using your own sources, your own clean data. So this is something using combination. I could go to ChatGPT, get a little snippet after a bit of back and forth, copy and paste it again down here as a new source. So I could copy and paste this text from ChatGPT from a bottom of a conversation that maybe gave me something useful to use here. And as long as that data is here under my sources, it's going to be able to interact with it using, again, this version of Gemini inside a notebook. Now on top, you could also share it. And this is a very familiar share box here, because this is the same thing that's inside of Google Drive, Google Sheets, Google Docs, right? So you could go ahead and add people here, notify them. You could copy the link here, and they could jump into your research, which makes it really, really useful to collaborate on any existing research that you're doing with your own set of sources. So because the context window is so huge, the fact that we can have millions of words here in our context window and have clean data, data that we specifically chose to add here, it can't hallucinate. It's not gonna go on the web and pull things that we don't want. Fantastic tool. I think this is going to completely change my workflow and how I take notes, so I wanted to bring it to your attention. I also wanted to point out this new course we roll out inside of Skill Leap this week. So we have a brand new AI powered chatbot for your website powered by ChatGPT. So if you're an entrepreneur, marketer, or if you have an agency, this is a great, very simple course, one of the best ways to roll out an AI powered chatbot. And we just updated some of our older courses and updated a new one too for design. So AI powered design for entrepreneurs and this ChatGPT powered chatbot as well. And you get access to all these courses and new courses all for one monthly subscription. So one of the best ways to keep up to date with AI. I'll link this below as well. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you on the next video.